of the Prophet. So to say that covering the head is not a part of Muslim identity is totally wrong. The beard is a part of the Muslim identity. Wearing the cap, or at least covering the head, whether with a scarf or with a ghatra like the Arabs do.
But sir, what about what Shahrukh said? And I know a lot of my friends say this. That, and all of us, no matter what faith we come in, we interpret our faiths differently. We take away some things, we don't do some things. Does that make us any less of Hindus, Muslims, Christians?
No, as I said, that Muslim is a person who submits civil to God. So you cannot say a liberal Muslim or a moderate Muslim. You can say a practicing Muslim or partly practicing or non-practicing. That's more correct. You know, and to understand Islam, don't look at the Muslim, don't look at me. Go to the scriptures. That is the reason I give talks on Islam and comparative religion.
But
so as far as the stereotype is concerned,
I find that a too narrow a definition of Islam. I personally reject all rituals. But Islam is part of my culture and my ethos. I'm as proud a Muslim as anybody else on this podium. But I don't have to wear it on my sleeve. And I think that's too narrow a definition of Islam.
I'd like to make a point.
Yeah.
They talked about people being stereotyped because of the beard and the cap and the hijab. Then we should say that all Sikhs are stereotyped. Anyone who wears a turban
is
and wears
not,
a beard.
It's not the same,
no. It's, not the,
it's
same,
not the same,
but what has happened, I'll tell you, in fact, India has become, in a strange sense, more liberal, because when Yusuf Khan entered the film industry and adopted the name of Dilip Kumar, that was a time when the whole of India was pretty prejudiced against Muslims, let me tell you. And Meena Kumari, who was she? She was also a Muslim. Why were all the names? Shah Rukh is an amazing example of a Muslim who is now the Badshah of Bollywood with a Muslim name. He didn't have to change his name. So something has happened.
Would you have ever changed your name?
To Akshay Kumar, yes. I would never change my name.
But now the reverse is happening, Barkha. I know of boys who come from small towns, want to become actors. They change their name to Khan because they think that's the badge of honor.
That's the way to go.
Barometer of success.
No, it's Dilip Khan or Kapoor.
Sorry, Najib.
But Dilip Kumar has now become Allah Rakha Rehman.
Yeah.
That's the change.
But
now he's no longer a star.
Yeah. Shahrukh, you want to make a point and then Soha and Madhani.
I just want to say one thing. I just want to know very clearly, and I'm a Muslim, and I want to know, is it more important for me to look Muslim and see Muslim or to feel Muslim? I fully respect the scriptures. I fully respect all the hadiths. I have read the Quran in my own way, in Arabic and in English. But I think its time has come, and this genuinely is an appeal, that it is more important to feel Muslim, to
than
feel
to look
Hindu,
it.
Than to look it. And if you do, I mean, if you do, it's absolutely cool. And if you don't, it's absolutely cool.
Doctor, I quick response to that, and I got two guests waiting to speak.
I think the best is to practice Muslim,
absolutely.
Number one.
Yes.
Appearing is important, but lower down. I'm not saying appearing is the most important. For a person to practice Islam is more important. Beard comes lower down. Beard is not in the 70 major sins that it's not there.
But you know, what about what Kabir is saying? And there was a story of a young boy whom I interviewed who studies in a convent school in Madhya Pradesh. And he's a poor boy. And the school rules wouldn't allow him to wear a beard. He went all the way to the Supreme Court to say, I must be allowed to keep my beard. Otherwise, I prefer not to study. And he actually dropped out of school for a while because of that. The Supreme Court eventually ruled in his favor. And that is my next question, and I want to take that to Madhani Sahab. Madhani Sahab, you're a very interesting character for me, because at one level, you have organized, as Alex said, all of these fatwas against terrorism and all of that. But you also had a resolution against the singing of Vande Mataram. And these kind of resolutions, I know many of my friends would say, is what stereotypes Muslims.
Baat ye hai ke Vande Mataram gana बिल्कुल अलग चीज है
अलग
हाँ गाने के लिए जिद करना बिल्कुल एक अलग चीज है कोई जबरदस्ती गवाना चाहे और नहीं गाएं या हम ये कहें हम नहीं गाते तो फिर हम स्टीरियोटाइप हो जाएंगे टेररिज्म की मुखालिफत करेंगे तो बहुत अच्छे हो जाएंगे ये जो डबल डबल मामला चलता है ये ठीक नहीं अभी मेरे दाढ़ी नहीं हो और कुर्ता पैजामा नहीं हो ये भी जो पगड़ी से तो लोग बहुत डरते हैं ना कहते हैं ये तो एक बच्चा एयरपोर्ट पे कहता है मदनी साहब नहीं मदनी साहब मामा मामा देखो बिन लादिन जा रहा है ना तो क्या हो गया है अब ये सब मैं उतार दूं तो मैं एक रीजनेबल मुसलमान हो सकता हूँ, एक ऐसा मुसलमान हो सकता हूँ जो बहुत अच्छा आदमी है। और अगर मैंने ये पहन लिया तो ख्यालात मेरे कितने अच्छे हों, ख्यालात, नजरियात, आइडियोलॉजी, ये है बेसिक चीज, या बेसिक चीज हमारी दिखने वाली चीज है।
That's the reverse stereotype, that the moment you see the beard and the skull cap, it's got to be a fundamentalist. Question, I want to get Soha in, she's been listening very patiently all this while. So as somebody who's grown up in a sense in a house of mixed religion, for you, in a sense, do you feel that public gaze? Do you feel, you know, many people have questioned my labeling of or my looking for the moderate Muslim. Yet there are others who say that we don't hear enough moderate voices. We either hear the religious voices or we hear the non-believing.
Because I don't think anybody is really interested in what the moderate Muslim has to say, because it's not very interesting. It's sort of boring. We're represented by extremists who have violent opinions, perhaps. I'm talking about vandals. And I think maybe also more recently, I was asking my mother when I was asked to come on this show. I said, in your time, when you married my father and you had an interreligious marriage, which presumably at that time, 40 years ago, was more controversial than it is today. Were you ever asked to defend your identity, to defend your choice of religion, what it means to be Hindu or Muslim, the way that we are today? And she said, no, not at all. It was a no comment issue. You just said no comment and you moved on in life. Over the past, maybe ever since I've been in cinema, certainly, it's an issue. And there is, people do ask me, do you feel aggravated by what is happening as a Muslim? Do you feel the need to stand up for your religion because it is being misrepresented in the media? And I think for me, religion is a very private matter. It's between my maker and me. And it's not something that I would want to discuss in any public forum, even this one. We should be talking about an Indian identity as opposed to a Muslim identity, I think.
Okay, I'm going to take that as my cue to take a break. But is it, as I said to Alec earlier, is it that simple? Is there also a sort of denial within the community? Is the secular debate caught up in a certain amount of dishonesty? And there's also the reverse stereotype. We'll take a quick break and then we'll take the questions that I'm sure a lot of people have here that's coming up after the break.